You're not afraid of the dark, are you? Don't be afraid. Come with me.
Do we really need to go through this? Hi. Oh, why am I so big? I'm really big. Hi. Oh, wait, I forgot my hands. Oh no, it's the wrong, enjoy this one then. Well, thank you so much for the gifted subs. I really appreciate that. Welcome on in, everyone. Hello, hello, hello. Better late than never, am I right? What's up, Gio? And we're back. Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the stream. Yes, doggy's okay. She's asleep. I even put on really soothing doggy music with doggy background on the TV. So she's okay. She's all right. half of her body is in the bed and half her body is out of it. How am I doing? I'm a little stressed. This is going to be TMI for the dog, so if you get grossed out very easily, I'm giving you guys 5 seconds to get out or close your ears for a minute. 5, 4, 3, 2. Oh, you stay up late to watch me. Thank you. Aw. Okay. Also, high fives. Yeah, she has worms. The vet and the breeder was like, yeah, it's super common. You can get worms from mother's milk and stuff like that. but when I woke up this morning, she had a mess, but there was this really long, translucent, Yeah, it was not good. I freaked out and I was really worried for her. And I had a really bad time, and I called the vet, and then I'm like, okay, well, the puppy was around Lindsay and her babies, so I had to get deworming stuff for humans and babies, and I went to the pharmacy, and then I went back to the place that I picked up Tui, and I got a little tablet, so she has a little tablet, and they're going to get all out of her system in, like, 6 to 7 hours, so I'm keeping a close eye on her. As someone who's had litters before, it's very common. Worming medicine is a good way with that. Yeah. I'm really glad that it's actually common. It's just such a gross thing to see come out of a teeny tiny little puppy. I'm like, bro, you pooped that. But it was dead, it wasn't moving or anything. So it's like, she's already had her deworming tablets for 4 times now. But with puppies, until they're 12 weeks, they need to have deworming tablets every 2 weeks. So it just happens sometimes. And I gave her medicine and she's asleep right now. And gross hit, she will be fine. Yeah. No, not suppository. I wrapped it in some ham and she ate it. So she'll be all good. But I was really worried. I've never had an animal with worms before. And when I woke up and I saw that thing, I was like, and then I had to go get groceries and I was really late and it was raining, so. Also, if you're going to bed, have a wonderful sleep. I'm a billion hours late. However, is it better that I streamed rather than canceling it? That I streamed late than not at all? Just checking. Because I didn't want to be like, it's canceled. I'll do it next week and then the next week and the next week. So, yeah. Yes. Okay. We appreciate it. Good. I'm happy you're streaming tonight. It's my birthday. Dude, happy birthday, man. Dr. No Shame, happy birthday. Happy freaking birthday, man. Can the stream wish Dr. No Shame a happy birthday? I'd really appreciate that. Oh, oops. My baby. I was so worried about her, but she's okay now. Okay. So, today we are playing Stanley Parable Deluxe Edition. Have I ever played this game? No. Do I know anything about it? No. I literally don't have the first clue. No idea. I don't know. So, because I'm going to be up late tonight anyway and watching over Doggy, you guys have a date with me. So it's just you and me for the next like 5 or 6 hours. You ready? Now, there are a few mods in here. I don't know what any spoilers would be. But there's any extreme backseating or spoilers, mods, do your thing. Also, Klux, welcome back for 10 months. Melena came to set of 2 open doors. She entered the door on her left. What? What kind of resub message is that? Huh? Also, Zara, welcome back. Welcome back for 15 months. So, also, this is a very, I heard, narrate-y kind of game, so put me on in the background, sit back, relax, enjoy the show, we're gonna kick it, and you know what, if you have nothing to do, well, you know what, this is best time is now, the time is now, best time is this moment, so, okay, she's good, okay. Do I put Doggy on the screen? I think I should just because I want to keep an eye on her. Can we change the game to Stanley Parable? Maybe. Can we maybe do that? Can we maybe do that? Maybe. Also, if I'm too big, I'm just... Oh my god. What are you doing? Oh my god, I love you. Thank you, Matt. Okay. Let me make sure that the game sound is nice and loud. I hear like calming music in the background. It's the weirdest fucking thing. Okay, Stanley is all the way up. Okay, and I didn't want to do this until I was ready to play. So, I don't know what this means. Everyone, welcome to Stanley Parable Deluxe Edition. Thank you for being here today. Welcome, Tui Elder. Welcome back for 6 months. Thank you. If it's late for you, I apologize, but if you're up late on a freaking Tuesday, I'm happy to have you here. Let's go. Yes, I'm playing Ultra Deluxe. Right now, it is 5:17 p.m. Accessibility settings can be accessed. Okay, you got it. Should I change any settings? Are we good? Oh, hey, it's like infinite on the computer. Oh, you have a day off. Awesome. Nice to meet you. Huh. I guess that's it. Change all the settings? Oh, wait. I just want to be sure subtitles are on. I don't know. This is one of your favorite games. Can we get a shout out for Hootie, by the way? Also, just in case, I don't want it to run slow or anything, but now it's all in it's all Hive. We'll just see how we go. Never the end. Okay. Oh, my bot's not on. Hang on. Sorry.
This is the story of a man named Stanley.
It's on now.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building
where
he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly.
Thank you, SJ. Welcome back.
And Stanley was happy. And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Oh, that's me. Okay. Okay, wait, let me take a sip of my soup. Hold on. Okay. I have no legs. I have no feet. Okay. Why do I make keyboard sounds away from the keyboard? Why is that the sound that I make? Open up! Hello? Where is everyone? Where is everybody? Hello?
Hello? All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
I'm going to tap on all the keyboards.
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. No matter, Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story.
How do you know that? Printer? 431?
431? 430? Oh, please. Are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times. Is that all that you think an achievement is worth?
What do you think for 5?
I can't just give these merits away for
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
5 clicks. Now suppose you were to click the door 20.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly.
Daniel, welcome back for 13 months. Okay, 1, 2, 3. I was tinkling yesterday. That was a very short amount of time that I did that too. What a weird time to catch me. This is deluxe edition. I don't know the difference. Wait, I'm gonna position my hand in a certain way. Oh, wrong door. Okay. Why didn't
I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go for 20 clicks into door number 417?
No! I'm not leaving. Okay, where's 417? Oh, what button was that? What's this button? What button am I pressing? 417. Where's 417? Good morning, everyone. Hi, Ghostifer. We are playing Stanley Parable Deluxe. Is there a deluxe on the options that I should be sure to change? Oh, Ultra Deluxe. Sorry, my bad, gamers. There. Ultra Deluxe. I don't know the fucking difference. Don't tell me either. What was that? Oh god, this game's gonna be the worst for me. Oh no, oh no. Are you playing castanets? It sounds like it, huh? Sorry. 417. Four 19. 420. Plant. Okay. 418. 418. 17. You said 417, right?
Oh, great. Now, go click a few times on door 437. Excellent. I think we're getting somewhere. Now, door 415. Let's give it 10 clicks or so.
Why am I doing this? Why am I doing this?
Now, back to door number 437. Let's see. How about you click on, well, I don't know, The copy machine.
Okay, okay, I can do that. I can do that. I can do that. Copy machine, I can do it. I can do it. Click.
All right, back to room
417.
Okay,
go.
I'm really
go.
Feeling it now. I think we're getting somewhere.
We're doing it. Okay, go. Hurry.
Okay, yeah. Now go climb on employee 419's desk.
Okay. 419. Going. Peak gaming. Thank you so much for picking up some merch. You're gonna love it. You're gonna love it, baby. Okay, where's 419?
Yes, this is great. You're putting it all on the line, Stanley. I like that. All right, let's keep it up. Go give me a few clicks on door 416.
Okay. I can do that.
We've almost got it.
Almost
now
there.
The copy machine. Do that.
Yeah. Wait. Hold on. I got it. Wait. Give me a second. No copy. Okay. Wait. Oh, wait. Hold on. What is it? No copy. Okay. It was. Okay. The party troll. What's this? Haha, funny.
This is for the people that need music.
Yeah. Haha, funny music time, let's go. What? It's supposed to be a full song. I don't want that, that's DMCA. I said no copyright. Haha, this is so funny, let's go. What was the number? I forgot the number. The copy machine, I forgot.
Finish it off, Stanley. 5 clicks on door 4-3. Yeah. We did it!
Woo!
Oh, wow. That felt amazing. Oh, you really earned it, Stanley. Nothing could hold you back. Yes, I'm very proud of how far we've come today. Just think, only a few minutes ago, you believed an achievement was worth 5 little clicks. Really, now? What were you thinking?
Okay, anyway. What's that? I like work. I just hate my boss. Ha ha ha! That's funny. Welcome back for 7 months. Did I miss
when
the zebra stream?
Stanley came to
oh
a set
God.
Of two open doors. He entered the door on his left. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
I think I'm going to screw with you guys so much more than you realize. I'm hacking.
Ah, yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth it, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago.
Okay, do not jump from the cargo lift while it's in motion.
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control of the story and no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone thinks you are very powerful.
Yay. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Stanley Parable, the Ultra Deluxe Edition.
All of his co-workers, oh please, are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times, is that all that you think an achievement is worth? No. I can't just give these merits away for such little effort. A measly 5 clicks. Now suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition. I have to say, I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause. Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly 50 clicks. No, I'm still not feeling it. I need this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
Okay. Funny, happy children's. No, that's not it. Cartoon vlog. No, that's not right.
Oh, great. Now, go click a few times on door 437. Excellent. I think we're getting somewhere. Now, door 415. Let's give it 10 clicks or so. Now, back to door number 437. Let's see. How about you click on, well, I don't know, the copy machine. All right, back to room 417. I'm really feeling it now. I think we're getting somewhere. Okay, now go climb
Welcome
on
back,
employee
Morgan.
419's desk.
Okay, we're going. Run. Thank you so much for the bits. Some random person. Hi, how are you?
How
random
are you
Popper.
Today?
Random Popper is doing much better. Much, much better this morning. Thank you for asking. We're 419. I can't count. Mr. Vettel, welcome back for 9 months. Nice to see you again. Jump. I said 419's desk. Get on the desk. Where can I get on the
yes,
desk?
Yes,
all right.
This is great. You're putting it all on the line, Stanley. I like that. All right, let's keep it up. Go give me a few clicks on
let's
door
Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
We've almost got it!
Here we go!
Now the copy machine, do that one again!
Woo! I don't know why they're not full songs, but that's okay! Woo!
Finish it off, Stanley! 5 clicks on door!
Woo!
Yes! We did it! Oh, wow.
I thought I'd get another achievement,
that's
sorry.
Amazing. Oh, you really earned it, Stanley. Nothing could hold you back. Yes, I'm very proud of how far we've come today. Just think, only a few minutes ago, you believed an achievement was worth 5 little clicks. Really, now? What were you thinking?
Hello, Miss Lena. How are you today? How is little Puppa?
Yeah, Puppy was a little sick this morning, but she's better now. Look at her. Look at the little fuzzy ball. She's okay. Holy crap, your model's freaking good. Holy frick, man. I'm always amazement from it. Hey, thanks. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you. Oh, sorry. Excuse me. All right. Where are we going next? All right.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Your sub got skipped? Prize balls. Wait, I see it. Resubbed for 10 months. Narrator lies. Happy subversary. Happy subversary for 10 months, dude. I'm so sorry. Welcome back. And thank you so much for continuing to support the channel. I really appreciate it. Thank you. You have glasses now? Yeah. Mythic. Hello. Okay, chat. Do we go to the left or right? Left or right. I kind of want to go back to the right. Like a little boop.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
No, I'll go back. Okay. I thought I could go back. Ah.
Wow. Yes. This room. What a beautiful room. What a gorgeous, gorgeous room. Thank goodness Stanley had taken this detour on his way to the meeting room. Life without having experienced this room was now too horrible even to consider. Yes, really, really worth it being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth it. At this point, Stanley's obsession with this room bordered on creepy and reflected poorly on his overall personality. It's possible that this is why everyone left. Stanley sat around waiting for more dialogue, but when a long time had passed and there was no more, he decided that the game was trying to send him a message.
Aw, Mythic, thank you. Welcome, welcome. Yes. Very good. Very good. Interesting. What could this be? Recommended. Is that committee? Yes, I. Yes, I am familiar. Yes. Yes. Quite right. I love mop. What was that? I don't know what that said. All right. Goodbye.
But at last, he'd had enough of the amazing room and took the first open door on his left to get back to business. Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't fired years ago. Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Sorry?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself, to put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Is the tapping over? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I will not tap. I'm done tapping.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this, to reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
What an interesting set of bricks. Oh, hey, thank you so much for picking up a hoodie. I appreciate it. Thank you. And a hat. Enjoy. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Ring is phoning.
As Stanley picked up the phone, a white light engulfed him, filling him not just with radiance, but with hope. Hope for a life reunited one... Wait. Oh, goodness. Stanley, did you just unplug the phone? No, that wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly. I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check. No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits. Not picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person. I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices. And to think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you'd made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
No, I know!
Choice! It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario,
video.
A hypothetical
I
real person in. Named Rupert has a choice. He could invent a machine that eliminates food shortages across the world to make life better for all people. Or he could spend years of hard work forgetting how to read. Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought, then provide an excuse
thort?
Why
a
you
thort?
Cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack."
My goodness, it's 4:30. I'm
Excellent.
Supposed to...
Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a healthy decision-making process. Most medical professionals recommend making at least 8 choices per day. Do you make more than 8? Less? And finally, if you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant, and the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Ah, welcome back. You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're properly informed on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
Okay.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and
oh,
dying.
No!
Imagine
Aww.
The main character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no
hey,
sense.
Hey, Raging,
at all.
Have a good day today.
We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
Huh. Okay. So now forcing me to go one direction? I don't like this. Hello? Hello?
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world. Now remember, all you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Oh, very nice. Okay, very good. No, I want to stay here. What do we do if we want to stay here? Can we click this a bunch of times? I don't want to go the other way. Door's stuck. I don't want to do it. I don't want to go. Real sneaking box. Welcome back for 3 months. Okay. I don't wanna do it. Okay, what?
Ruined. I can't believe after everything we talked about that you, my story, you've destroyed my work. Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone, left here like so much garbage? It's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? Mm-hmm. I can't erase that knowledge. Mm-hmm. I'll have to live with it forever.
Okay.
Reliving its impossibility forever.
Okay.
I couldn't live that way. Mm-hmm. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do? What do I... No, I have to. I have to shut the game down.
Wait,
I
what?
I have to. Was so clever. Now look where we are. My entire game is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you run it into the ground.
Where's my gremlin voice?
What, did you think that would be funny?
What?
You just had to see? Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley?
Mm-hmm.
He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it.
Uh-huh.
That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it?
Uh-uh.
That there's a world outside of you? You're a child.
Yeah.
Oh, my story. If you'd just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect.
Yeah.
I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard to make...
Uh-huh.
is behave exactly as Stanley would.
That
means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first.
Yeah.
I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Okay.
All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay.
No! Why did you do that?
Quickly,
hurry back. Behave exactly as Stanley would.
Okay.
That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first.
Okay.
I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task.
Uh-huh.
Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Uh-huh.
All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back. Behave exactly as Stanley would.
Okay.
That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first.
Yeah.
I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task.
Okay.
Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Yeah.
All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back.
Huh?
Behave exactly as Stanley would.
Uh-huh.
That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first.
Okay.
I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
mm-hmm.
he entered the door on his left.
Okay.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back. Behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
okay.
he entered the door on his left. No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back. Behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task.
Okay.
Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right.
Okay.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors,
okay.
he entered the door on his left.
Okay. Thank you for the resub, Strippin'.
Tips for not getting fired.
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Mm.
Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Let it ball up inside you, take it out and passive-aggressively on other coworkers, and resent coworkers for not so- okay? Using slides to assure employees that everything's okay. Make sure your slide has a slick blue graphic in the header and throw some bevel on all the text. This will ensure a calm and productive work environment. Everyone's unique. You, most of all. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Am I Irish? Yeah. 100%. Mm-hmm. Yes. Rate it which charts on the same slide depict the same information. Hmm. Rate of increase in graphs per slide. Please no more charts, I'm begging. Stop. The boss appreciation minute. On your boss appreciation minute worksheet, circle the top 20 things you love most about your boss, fill out in triplicate, and return to your boss appreciation specialist. Solving interpersonal conflict. If you ever find yourself in a conflict with another diligent employee like yourself, but more inclined towards conflict, unless you're the kind of person who initiates conflict, why did we hire you?
plant life, football, transcend, success, a boat, pollution, less air, comatose, spring break, hope, clear skin, lunch, charts, nature. Tips for not getting fired, talk less. Do unbelievably amazing work all the time, every day, with no expectation of promotion or recognition. Don't get fired. Huh. What kind of work do we do here? Huh. Okay.
Hmm. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
I don't want to. Hi, Giga! Can I get a shot for Giga? How you doing, dude? Hi, Giga. Nice to see you. Hello? What the fuck? Wait, what? What? Hello?
Stepping inside his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, until he saw the door with a voice receiver next to it. Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he knew the passcode. He had seen it on his boss's computer just last week. Nightshark 115. Was this the code to open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out. Stanley had been trained never to speak up, but now he would draw from within himself the courage to face the unknown. He drew a sharp breath and then spoke the code. Stanley spoke the code. Nightshark 115. He spoke it into the receiver, right there on the wall.
Panda!
I'm sorry, is there a problem? You didn't mishear me, did you? Please speak the code into the receiver. Otherwise, we can't get on with the story. This is a crucial step.
Spaghetti.
Okay, fine. You're not gonna do it. But you know what? It's pretty humiliating to bring you this far, only for you to suddenly decide you have better things to do. I asked you for this one single thing, for your respect. The kind of respect Stanley shows for his choices. He knows what it means to take a story seriously. If you didn't want to see what I had to show you, then why did you come here? You had a choice, you know. You could have gone through the door on the right. You could have done whatever the hell you wanted over there. Why did you come this way? Speak. Say something to me. Explain yourself, you coward. You...
Huh?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Yeah.
Stanley? Hello? Is everything okay?
Yeah.
Stanley, please. I need you to make a choice. I need you to walk through the door.
Huh?
Are you listening to me?
Okay.
Can you hear me?
Bye-bye.
Is everything all right? Stanley, this is important.
Thank you guys so much for the stream today.
It needs you to make a decision.
I had a really good time. I knew this game was going to be good.
Whatever choice you make is just fine. They're both correct. You cannot be wrong here. We can work together. I'll accept whatever you do. I simply need you to take that step forward, please. Choose.
Man, I knew you guys were saying this is a good game. I didn't know it was this good.
Anything.
It was a little bit short, but I really liked it. Anyway, thanks for letting me play even though I was late.
The story needs it. So, you hear me? Are you there? Are you listening to this? Stanley, are you there?
Thanks, guys.
Okay. It's okay, I can wait.
Okay, who should we raid?
You need time to decide.
Okay.
Time to make sure your choice is correct. That is the best choice. That's all right. I'll wait for you to decide what's the right thing to do. Take as much time as you need.
Thank you.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Didn't commit to the
when
bit.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Uh-huh. Doug. Oh. Doug? Oh.
What if we never make a decision? Ah, fuck it. Let's go.
Yet there was not a single person here
Bye-bye.
Either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Okay. Boone waited in there for 3 hours? Oh my fucking god, Boone. I'm not surprised. At all. What's that? Ooh! To be rich, is it a crime? To make crimes, is it rich? What a life it would be to have to pick just one. Extreme bathrooms. He has nothing to say about this? Oh, congratulations on graduation and good luck tomorrow, okay? Good night and have a wonderful sleep. And tomorrow's gonna be awesome. Bye, Senior Bob. Bye-bye. I really think a handful of people thought I was ending my stream. I'm pretty sure. Oh. Ooh. Oh.
Uh-huh.
Alright, this is my stop. Okay, well. What's this room?
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life.
Wait, what?
Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him?
Okay,
what
now.
What he could not have known. Was that the keypad behind
genuinely
the
confused.
Boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. and so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
Eight.
Forgot, but it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself. And Stanley got the hell along with the story.
Yeah.
Well, whoop-de-doo.
Yeah.
Kraken's gone on vacation, and now I'm listening to Lana make baby noises on an elevator. I hope he's happy. I don't know, is Kraken still in here? Nope. Well, I'm sure he is. Is this a piano? That sure sounds like one. Nailed it. Hello? Hello? Oh, this isn't the right one. Beep. Beep. Beep.
Descending deeper
what happened?
Into the building,
where's my little baby
Stanley
voice?
Realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest.
What happened to it? It's gone.
To think for
my baby voice
the
is gone.
Nature of his
what
job.
Just happened?
Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go
cartoon.
Unanswered
what?
For long.
Just hard tune, baby. Yeah. I honestly have no idea what happened to it. Now it's just a singy thing. I think the narrator broke it. What the fuck?
Why can't I sound like a little baby?
Baby.
I love my puppy so much, puppy. Tui's chewing on stuff. Look at her chewing like puppies do. She's chewing and sleepy. Can I put auto-tune on the narrator? No. I don't know how to do that. Is that a husky puppy? That's fucking hilarious. No, it's not. It's a Pomeranian. Tui's chewing. Look at her chewing on stuff. Tui's chewing. Chewing, chewing. Okay, anyway, I'm done.
I don't know where my baby voice went. It's fucking gone.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death. The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Yeah!
Okay, hang on, I gotta check a puppy. 1 second, enjoy the sounds. Wait.
As the machine whirred
into
motion,
more game.
And and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever.
Well, I'm a little worried
Stanley
better.
Can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped Amnesia, forever in his narrow vision of what this world is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man.
What?
So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life.
Wait.
Farewell, Stanley.
Wait, what? Hold on, give me 1 second, game. Game, give me 1 second.
Farewell, Stanley.
Wait, what?
Cried the narrator.
What?
As Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated.
Wait, what?
As the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
What? What? Okay, be right back. 1 second. I'm just gonna check on Doggy, okay? Okay, thanks for being patient. I'm just gonna stop every now and again to check on Puppy. I will put this here as a text. Let's see, text. BRB checking on Pupper, and I'll just put that up every time I gotta stop. For you guys checking in, I gave Tui some medicine. So every now and again, I'm just going to be like stopping to check on her. That's all. Checking all. Okay.
Here you go.
Yeah, I should probably check Pupper again. No, she's okay. She's right. She's just chewing her little thingamabob. Okay, you guys ready? Okay, so apparently another narrator came through. Lied to me about my death. And now we're here. Stanley Parable.
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
What the hell?
When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
The set of the two open doors was the very first concrete piece of the Stanley Parable's design. Once this room was created, the rest of the game emerged as an extension of it, an exploration of the contradiction this room posed. The pacing of this opening section was important to get right. This corridor has been moved and altered to make sure the player reaches the two doors in a good time. This blueprint shows the office from the beginning of the game. The path from Stanley's office to the two doors was the first part of the game that was built. Sections have been added and altered throughout development, though the core layout remains almost identical to the first iteration. Nature paintings. Filing cabinets. Office computers. Maintenance room. Okay, looking great. Narrator emails. I want to get out of here. Let me out. Let me out.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free. Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No. Perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save those two. You can stop the program before they both fail.
No.
Escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let
Hi, Pix. We're going to be playing a game with Pix tomorrow, by the way. Be sure you tune in. Can we get a shout out for Pix? Hi! You know, good timing. Good timing. All right.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
How you doing, Pix?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
What time is it for you, man? I feel it's, like, so late for everyone.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
I'm doing okay. You want to see doggy? Hi, puppy. Two AM. Oh my gosh, yeah, she just breathes.
Yet,
and it's cute. I don't know how she does
person
it
here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Coming to a staircase,
AM?
Stanley walked upstairs
God.
To his boss's office.
I breathe and I
stepping into
okay.
his manager's office. Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication
yeah, it is really
of
late.
Any human life.
You guys are watching
what
a late stream.
Mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody. He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf, looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to his situation. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose
8:20
be?
8:20 a.m.?
In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet.
Wait, this is new.
And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Well, I'm glad you guys are here both in the morning and the evening. Thank you for being here. Hi, everyone. I've only been playing this for like an hour and 15, maybe like an hour, but I'm really curious how this game has 5 hours of content.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Okay. No, it'll be in the morning when we play tomorrow. I think it's gonna be like 10 a.m. tomorrow for me, playing with you guys.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength?
Yeah, I always have to wake up early for collabs. That's okay. I live in Narnia, I understand. What is this place?
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers.
Holy hell.
The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
I've never played a game, any of the games before this. This is my first time ever playing this kind of game. Okay, moving on. Okay, excellent. Okay, employee observation protocol. Okay, excellent. Moving on. Okay.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Uh-huh. Okay.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable.
It's like the Truman Show.
Was it even possible?
In Game Boy?
Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Are you guys too young for the Truman Show? There's gotta be some people that are as old as me or older.
But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content, walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life. For he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
What if I didn't do that, though? Let's check on Doggy, 1 second. You okay, puppy? She's okay. I don't want to. Good night, everyone who's going to bed. Thanks for hanging out today. What's 5 mean? Okay.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew...
No, I was saying goodnight to Provost's death.
It was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Mm-hmm.
didn't just activate the controls, did you? After they kept you enslaved all these years, you go and you try to take control of the machine for yourself. Is that what you wanted? Control? Stanley, I applaud your effort, I really do. But you need to understand, there's only so much that machine can do. You were supposed to let it go, turn the controls off, and leave. If you want to throw my story off track, you're going to have to do much better than that. I'm afraid you don't have nearly the power you think you do. For example, and I believe you'll find this pertinent, Stanley suddenly realized he had just initiated the network's emergency detonation system. In the event that this machine is activated without proper DNA identification, nuclear detonators are said to explode, eliminating the entire complex.
Yeah.
How long until detonation then? Let's say, 2 minutes.
Okay.
Ah, now this is making things a little more fun, isn't it, Stanley? It's your time to shine.
Okay.
You are the star. It's your story now.
Five.
Shape it to your heart's desires.
Five.
Oh, this is much better than what I had in mind. What a shame we have so little time left to enjoy it. Mere moments until the bomb goes off. But what precious moments each one of them is. More time to talk about you, about me, where we're going, what all this means. I barely know where to start. What's that?
Ten.
You'd like to know where your co-workers are?
Green.
A moment of solace before you're obliterated. All right, I'm in a good mood.
Charge.
You're gonna die anyway. I'll tell you exactly what happened to them. I erased them. I turned off the machine. I set you free.
One.
Of course, that was merely in this instance of the story.
One.
Sometimes when I tell it, I simply let you sit there in your office forever, pushing buttons endlessly and then dying alone.
One.
Other times, I let the office sink into the ground, swallowing everyone inside, or I let it burn to a crisp.
One.
I have to say this, though. This version of events has been rather amusing. Watching you try to make sense of everything and take back the control wrested away from you, it's quite rich. I almost hate to see it go.
Charge.
But I'm sure whatever I come up with on the next go-around will be even better. My goodness, only 34 seconds left. But I'm enjoying this so much. And you know what? To hell with it. I'm going to put some extra time on the clock. Why not? These are precious additional seconds, Stanley. Time doesn't grow on trees. Oh, dear me. What's the matter, Stanley? Is it that you have no idea where you're going or what you're supposed to be doing right now? Or did you just assume when you saw that timer that something in this room was capable of turning it off? I mean, look at you. Running from button to button, screen to screen, clicking on every little thing in this room. These numbered buttons. No, these colored ones. Or maybe this big red button. Or this door. Everything, anything, something here will save me. Why would you think that, Stanley? That this video game can be beaten?
Three.
One solved? Do you have any idea what your purpose in this place is? Stanley. You're in for quite a disappointment.
I like
But here's a spoiler for you. That timer isn't a catalyst to keep the action moving along.
Five.
It's just seconds ticking away to your death. You're only still playing instead of watching a cutscene because I want to watch you for every moment that you're powerless. To see you made humble.
Dog.
This is not a challenge. It's a tragedy. You wanted to control this world, that's fine. But I'm going to destroy it first, so you can't. Take a look at the clock, Stanley. That's 30 seconds you have left to struggle. 30 seconds until a big boom and then nothing. No ending here. Just you being blown to pieces. Will you cling desperately to your frail life? Or will you let it go peacefully? Another choice? Make it count. Or don't. It's all the same to me. All a part of the joke. And believe me, I will be laughing at every second of your inevitable life from the moment we fade in until the moment I say, happily ever up.
Dog. Dog end. Okay.
All of his co-workers were... Wait, no. This isn't the right office, is it?
Wait, what?
Is this Stanley's office?
Oh! You said something different! What? Dan, welcome back for 14 months! Good morning!
Baron, welcome back for 3 months. Nice to see you again. Thank you. Why is this different?
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. The lounge was sublime, a work of art. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
We haven't done this before.
But Stanley didn't want to go back to the office. He wanted to wander about and get even further off track. So now, in order to get back, he needed to go, from here it's, left.
Doc? Whoa. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, no. Oh. No, it's to the right. My mistake.
Oh, I do not know what the reason is for sleeping on the pupette. I cannot...
No, not the right. Why would I have ever said it was to the right? What was I thinking? It's clearly... Oh, dear, would you hold on for a minute, please?
What?
Now, let's see. We went down right, left... Down,
how did I get the dog ending? It's a very right. Secret ending. You have to do several endings in order.
I've got it now. This story is absolutely, definitely this way.
Okay. Okay. Oh.
No. This isn't right at all. You're not supposed to be here yet. This is all a spoiler. Quick, Stanley, close your eyes. Okay. We just have to get back to, Who am I kidding? It's all rubbish now. The whole story completely unusable. How about, rather than waste my time trying to salvage this nonsense, we'll just restart the game
No.
This time, suppose we don't wander so far off track.
Let's just keep going here.
Okay.
No, please.
From the top. All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. When Stanley... Wait.
Oh my god!
What?
What the heck?
No, I restarted. I swear, I definitely restarted the game over, completely fresh. Everything should be... Oh, did something change?
Which
Stanley,
door?
Did you change anything when we were back in that room with all the monitors?
Mm-hmm.
Did you move the story somewhere or a...
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. Why am I asking you? I'm the one who wrote the story.
Yeah.
It was right here just a minute ago.
Yeah.
I know for sure that it's here somewhere.
Uh-huh.
Okay, then. It's an adventure.
Adventure!
Come, Stanley. Let's find the story.
I want my gremlin voice back. Can you help me find it?
Weep, boop, boop, boop.
Nope, that's not it.
It's kind of like this. A little? Kind of maybe. No, it's not really the right... Maybe?
kind of like this a little bit. I don't think. Maybe? No.
I'll say it. This is the worst adventure I've ever been on. I can promise you there definitely was a story here before. Do we need to restart the game
again?
No! Well, I find it unlikely that we'll ever progress by starting over and over again. But it's got to be better than this. Okay, let's give it a shot. Why not?
No!
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, yep, it's worse. I might be remembering this wrong. It's possible the story is back where we just came from.
Okay.
Why don't we go back the other direction and see if we missed anything?
Yeah. Should I bring out the gremlin? Hang on, everybody. I think I got a special guest on the way. One second. Any special guest here? Oh. Julie sounds like a gremlin too when she boofs. Ow! Oh my god. Can I auto-tune her? Oh, what's it? Ow! Ow! Hello? Oh. What the heck? It's not auto-tune anymore. This is the gremlin voice. What the heck? It came back. I didn't even do anything. Hi, guys. I'm back, baby. Okay, what do we want? Do we want the real Lima to go away? Or do we... Why am I getting so little? Okay. What do we do? Did we put this ugly one away? Can we have both? Yes. Where do I put it? What do you want me to put me? Where do I go? Right here? Where do you want... On head? Yeah, but then I... Oh! See, I'm gonna fall... I can't go on the head. I'm gonna fall. My shoulder? This little thing right here? I mean, I guess that works. What do you think? Should I stay on the shoulder? A lap? Okay, bye! The lap goes down here. Where am I? You want me to lap? I go down here. Bye. Whoop. Hi. Okay. I'm just gonna be right here. I'm just gonna be right here. Okay. We're here now. Okay, I'm just gonna zoom in a little bit. Okay, excuse me. Resume the game!
Aha! I knew we'd miss something.
Huh?
The story. Here it comes.
No. This isn't right. Hello?
No, wait. Never mind. Not the story. Okay, let's head back the other way and retrace our steps. Now this... Well, I'll be honest, I don't recognize this place at all. Is this the story? I don't think so. Mm-mm. I can't quite recall, but I believe my story took place in an office building. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Do you remember, Stanley?
No.
Well, do you know what? Since I've completely forgotten what we were supposed to be doing, how about this?
Uh-huh.
You win! Congratulations!
Yeah!
I know you put in a lot of hard work, and it really paid off. So,
Thank you. Good job!
Oh, no. No, I don't feel right about this at all. We both know you didn't put in any actual work for that win. Some people win fair and square, and this was not one of those situations. Okay, I'm getting weirded out by whatever this place is. I don't care what might happen this time, I have to restart. All right, I've got a solution. This time, to make sure we don't get lost, I've employed the help of the Stanley Parable Adventure Line.
Okay.
Just follow the line. How simple is that?
The dog is watching TV, look. Oh, hi, doggy. That's where the TV is. You see something nice on the TV, Miss Tui? What do you see? You looking at the stuff on TV? Yeah? Yeah? What you doing, puppy? Uh-oh, don't do that. That's not very good. Please don't do that. Uh-oh. Okay, thank you. Looking at me? Is it me you're looking at? Hello? Hi. Hi, Tui. Okay, bye-bye. Okay.
You see? The line knows where the story is. It's over in this direction. Onward, Stanley, to destiny. Though, here's a thought. Wouldn't wherever we end up be our destination, even if there's no story there? Or to put it another way, is the story of no destination still a story? Simply by the act of moving forward, Are we implying a journey such that a destination is inevitably conjured into being via the very manifestation of the nature of life itself? Whoa. Hang on. That got a bit weird back there. Well, I'd like to apologize. Not sure where I was going with all that. You know what? I think what we need right now is a bit of music to lighten the mood.
Welcome, and thank you so much for the book. Thank you so much for subbing to the channel. Thank you for your bright and supporting the channel.
Cut the music, go back, and look at that fern. Stanley, this fern will be very important later in the story.
Okay.
Make sure you study it closely and remember it carefully. Wait, what? We're back at the office? No. Yeah. Line, you do know we're looking for the Stanley Parable, right? The story?
Yeah.
Is any of this ringing a... Oh, no, not again. Line, how could you have done this to us? And after we trusted you, after everything we've been through, you... Oh, I can't take this anymore. To hell with it. Restart.
Have a good day work, D-Man. Okay, here we go again.
You know what, Stanley? I say forget the adventure line. What's it ever done for us? Huh? We're intelligent people, right? Why can't we make up our own story? Something exciting, daring, mysterious. Ooh, this all sounds perfectly doable. Why don't we simply start wandering in... Well, I don't know. How about this direction?
Okay!
Now... Yes, this is exciting. Just me and Stanley forging a new path, a new story. Well, it could be anything. What do you want our story to be? Go wild. Use your imagination. Whatever it might be, Stanley, I'm ready for it.
Okay, there once was a ducky.
Oh, no, not you again. Stanley, I'd also like to veto the lion from having any role in our awesome new story. No lions or monitor rooms.
Okay.
Just don't acknowledge it. We should be fine.
Okay. There once was a ducky, and his name was Spelunky, and he likes to eat grass. I said, hey, ducky, you shouldn't do that. And then he got it stuck in his ass.
A choice. We get to make a decision. From here, the story is in our control.
Huh?
How important, we mustn't squander the opportunity. In fact, I believe I need a minute to think here. Just walk in circles for a minute.
No!
Okay, so I know that each door has to lead somewhere.
Okay.
Which means that somewhere, the place where we're trying to go, there must be a reverse door that leads here.
Mm-hmm.
And that in turn means that our destination corresponds with the counter-inverted reverse door's origin.
Mm-hmm.
So starting from the right, let us ask, will taking the right door lead us to where we're going? And since the answer is clearly yes, then by all accounts, the door on the right is the correct one. Another victory for Roger. Come, Stanley. Our destiny awaits.
What? Oh, how did I get here? Do we have a maintenance room? End up at the monitor room? Need to restart the game. First, we started to cover the two doors, and now as many additional doors. I was wondering, restart. Office now dead end. Turn around. But I'm losing that. End up in another building. Restart. Adventure line, not this philosophy. Fourth, restart. Venture unexplored territory. Find the line again. Find the condition ending. Schedule for the restart. We forget about the restart. Stanley attempts for the story, but is prevented. There's no longer an office, simply black space. Wanders in the blackness, find a bookstore, get bored and leave. And there he's gone after a long time, Stanley. Dice. He dies. He dies? Okay.
Oh, hold up, what's this? The confusion ending. You're telling me that's what this is? It's all one giant ending? And we're supposed to restart the game eight times? That's really how all this goes?
Yeah.
It's all determined? So now, according to the schedule, I restart again. Then what? Am I just supposed to forget?
Yeah.
Well, what if I don't want to forget?
Oh, don't.
My mind goes blank simply because it's written here on this thing. Wall.
Yeah.
Well, who consulted me?
The dice.
Why don't I get to decide?
You don't.
Why don't I get a say in all of this?
You can't.
Is it really?
Yeah.
No, it can't be.
No.
I don't want it to be.
Me neither.
I don't want the game to keep restarting.
Me too.
I don't want to forget what's going on.
Me neither.
I don't want to be trapped like this.
Me too.
I won't restart the game.
Don't.
I won't do it. I won't do
okay.
it. I won't do it.
Okay.
And the timer stopped?
Huh?
Does that mean, did we do it?
If I
break the
back.
Cycle? The, whatever it is that made this schedule?
Mm-hmm.
How would we even know? Will someone come for us? Will something happen?
Hello?
So.
Hello?
Okay. I guess now we just wait. You know, I suppose in some way that this is a kind of story. Wouldn't you agree? I'm not quite sure if we're in the destination or the journey. Though they're always saying that life is about the journey and not the destination. So I hope that's where we are right now. We'll find out, won't we? Eventually. Well, in the meantime, if you... All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Okay.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here, so he turned around and got back on track. There was nothing here. No choice to make, no path to follow, just an empty broom closet. No reason to still be here. It was baffling that Stanley was still just sitting in the broom closet. He wasn't even doing anything. At least if there was something to interact with, he'd be justified in some way.
I have an idea.
He's literally just standing there doing sweet F.A.
What's F.A.? Lowercase, welcome back for 9 months.
Are you really still in the broom closet?
Yeah.
Standing around doing nothing?
Uh-huh.
Why? Please offer me some explanation here. I'm genuinely confused.
I'm doing something right now. Hi. 3 first-time chatters, welcome to the stream.
You do realize there's no choice or anything in here, right?
Yes.
If I'd said Stanley walked past the broom closet, at least you would have had a reason for exploring it to find out. But it didn't even occur to me because literally this closet is of absolutely no significance to the story whatsoever.
Okay.
I never would have thought to mention it.
Just gonna do this and this.
Maybe to you this is somehow its own branching path.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe when you go talk about this with your friends, you'll say, "Ow! Did you get the broom closet ending?"
Mm-hmm.
The broom closet ending was my favorite.
Mm-hmm.
I hope your friends find this concerning. Stanley was fat and ugly and really, really stupid. He probably only got the job because of a family connection. That's how stupid he is.
Well,
that all with
back.
Drug money. Also, Stanley is addicted to drugs and
what?
Hookers.
That's not true! Don't listen! That's not true! That's not true!
Well, I've come to a very definite conclusion about what's going on right now. You're dead.
No.
You got to this broom closet, explored it a bit, and were just about to leave because there's nothing here, when a physical malady of some sort shut down your central nervous system and you collapsed on the keyboard. Well, in a situation like this, the responsible thing is to alert someone nearby so as to ensure that your body is taken care of before it begins to decompose.
Mm-hmm.
Hello? Anyone who happens to be nearby? The person at this computer is dead. They
no.
have fallen prey to any number of your countless human physiological vulnerabilities.
He's lying!
It's indicative of the long-term sustainability of your species. Please remove their corpse from the area and instruct another human to take their place, making sure they understand basic first-person video game mechanics and filling them in on the
no.
history of narrative
the dog tropes
is playing
with their toys on the poopy area.
So the irony and insightful commentary
no.
of this game is not lost on them.
Doggy, no!
Right, just step out into the hall.
No! Julie, please! Why? Why do you do this? I already gave you a bath today! Like, that toy is new, too! Oh, God. She just rolls around in her own piss. She's a piss dog! I didn't sign up for a piss dog! I gave her a bath yesterday, and the day before, and today! Because she rolls in it! Piss baby! Yeah, that's you, little piss baby! You bring your toys when you piss! Ah! God! I clean you every day! I clean you every day! Jace, have a good sleep! Piss baby! You brought your brand new toy into your piss area! Huh? I love you, Chewie! 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 Piss, baby. Yeah. What were we doing again? Oh, we're in the closet. Okay, anyway.
Ah, second player. It's good to have you on board. I guarantee you can't do any worse than the person who came before you.
You wanna bet?
You too. Unbelievable. I'm at the mercy of an entire species of invalids. Perhaps there's a monkey nearby you can hand the controls to.
Oh, yeah, I do, actually.
Look, you can hammer out the details. I'm not particularly picky.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just be waiting for when you're ready to pick up the story again.
She's probably worse than me. Look at her rolling around in her piss. Just look at her, but she fucking stinks. God damn it. Anyway, what are we doing? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Coming to a staircase,
ooh.
Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
This is new. This is new. I like this. What's this area? Whoa.
But Stanley just couldn't do it.
No.
He considered the possibility of facing his boss. Admitting
yeah.
he had left his post during work hours,
uh-huh.
he might
Oopsie.
Be fired for that.
Mm-hmm.
And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk?
No.
All because he believed everyone had vanished.
Yeah.
His boss would think he was crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And then something occurred to Stanley.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, he thought to himself,
Oopsie.
Maybe I am crazy.
Yeah.
All of my coworkers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment
yeah.
for no
Look
reason
back,
at all. None of it made any logical sense.
Yeah.
And as Stanley pondered this, he began mm-hmm. to make other strange observations.
Mm-hmm.
For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically
Oopsie.
Behind him wherever he went?
Mm.
And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar.
Mm.
Were they simply repeating?
Mm.
No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be real.
Mm.
And at last, he came to the conclusion that
Oopsie.
Had been on the tip of his tongue.
Mm.
He just hadn't found the words for it.
Mm.
I'm dreaming, he yelled.
Mm-hmm.
This is all a dream. Oh,
Oopsie.
What a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all.
Yeah.
And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid. So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above the ground. Then he imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field. And it too appeared. It was so much fun. And Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up. How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking? Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could it be? Was Stanley simply deceiving himself, believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley. After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too. Surely, surely, if he could just... He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control. That this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin, the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons. Please, it's all I want. I want my apartment, and my wife, and my job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been. My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine.
Okay.
I am okay.
Okay. Huh? No.
Stanley began screaming. Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I'm real.
Dream.
I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my
voice?
Who am I? Who am I? And everything went black. This is the story of a woman named Mariella.
What? Can you get a shout for Octo?
Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy. This much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal. I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this, and in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day. The very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career, and by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this, so it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body. And then she turned and ran.
Silver? Oh, thank God. Are we back?
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. Content? What does that mean, new content?
Bye-bye! New content?
Hello, and thank you for playing the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe.
Okay, you're welcome.
As you may know, the Stanley Parable was a video game released in 2013 on home computers.
Okay.
After receiving critical and commercial success, it was expanded upon in 2022 with the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, reimagining of the game for consoles and home computers.
Okay.
The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe features exciting new content that broadens and expands the world of the Stanley Parable, delighting audiences the world over.
Okay.
Please, step inside and see what thrilling new adventures await in the Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe.
Oh, well, this sounds delightful. I'm very excited to see the thrilling new Ultra Deluxe content.
Okay.
Okay, so far it's an elevator. Nothing special yet, but I'm sure it's just the beginning of a mesmerizing adventure.
Okay.
Is it broken? What's going on here? Should we be moving somewhere or... Oh, there we go. All right,
okay.
Finally, at long last, it's on to the new content. I've never been more ready. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have to say, initial impressions of Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, mostly tedious. It's as if, Oh, okay. Let's see the content. Give me the content, Stanley.
Yeah!
All right, let's see, it's the jump circle.
Yeah!
Is that it?
Mm-hmm.
Surely that's not all the new content.
Yeah.
There has to be something else, right?
Mm.
Goodness. Another elevator. Stanley, I have to say, initial impressions of this game are not positive. It's just elevators and jumping. Is this what passes for exciting new content?
Yeah.
If this is new content, then I could just read you the whole dictionary. There's 20 hours of new content right there. Hell, I could count to 30 trillion. You could put that on the box. The Stanley Parable Ultra Deluxe, now with over 1,000 hours of new content. And if... Oh, wait. There's more. Very good.
What
yes.
Else?
I knew there had to be something else. Mm-hmm. Let's see it. I'm ready for whatever it is.
Mm-hmm. Hello? Oh, okay. Here we go.
That's it? Oh, you've got to be kidding me. You see, Stanley? This is what happens when greedy video game developers with no respect for their fan base rush a cheap expansion to market for no reason other than to make an easy dollar. And don't get me started on the level of craftsmanship that's gone into it. In fact, I'm looking right now at the game's achievements, and it's hard to believe one of them actually says, "Test achievement, please ignore." What quality assurance department signed off on this? I'm infuriated and I'm offended, and I intend to find these people on Twitter and hold them personally accountable.
Okay.
It's my fault, Stanley. I built up too much anticipation around the new content, I'm afraid. It could never have lived up to such expectations.
Mm-hmm.
If you're still with me, why don't we just reset the game?
No.
And we'll try to get back to what the Stanley Parable is really about.
No.
No frills, no gimmicks. Just you and me having a great time together like always. What do you say, friend?
Mm-mm. Wait.
What's this? Hello? Hmm? What's happening? There it is.
Psst! Stanley! Come over here!
No.
In the vent. I want to show you something.
I know how quick I gotta go up the stairs.
Oh. You don't want to see the cool surprise I made for you?
I
well,
know.
Fine. You're a dork anyway, so who cares?
Oh. Well, I guess I could go back and look at that. 1 second. Okay, 1 second, narrator. I'm coming. Aww. Okay, sorry, narrator. Petulant.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet, there was not a single person here either.
Okay.
Feeling a wave of disbelief,
okay.
Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Coming
okay.
to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Okay. No, I don't want to do that again. Okay.
The moment he entered his manager's office, Stanley froze in his tracks.
Nuh-uh.
Not a living soul anywhere.
Yeah.
Could he really be all alone? This was too much for Stanley to take. Too much for any man to take. He fell to his knees, bursting into half moans, half sobs, the
okay.
guttural retching of life from a man denied any hope,
what?
Any reason to keep going.
That's not happening.
Here on the floor, he lay prone, paralyzed by fear for nearly a full hour. But when at
what?
Last he began to move about and survey the situation,
okay.
he found a keypad behind the boss's desk.
Ooh, okay,
what
yeah.
could it mean?
Right here.
Was it a sign of hope
four,
for Stanley's
seven, eight,
future?
Three.
Alas, it was
seven.
Not. For although this keypad guarded the terrible secret of Stanley's past, it had been assigned a 4-digit code so devious and so random that no man could ever hope to guess it.
You okay?
2845. Statistically, nearly impossible to guess blindly, ever.
You okay? Doggy?
Stanley just sat around twiddling his thumbs. Trying to input anything on the device was useless, since he could never possibly know that the combination was 2845.
What are you doing?
Two, eight, four, five.
Can I camp it? I don't know what she's doing.
For God's but it turns out that the panel's emergency override kicked in, and the door just opened all by itself. And Stanley got the hell along with the story. Well, whoop-de-doo.
Good night, Intoxic. We have a wonderful sleep. Good night, Digimora. I'll try to get to the vent again. I don't know how to do that. Oh, she's just going for it. This girl's your fan? Hi, escape artist. Nice to meet you. Man, this is really exciting to watch, actually. I'm not gonna lie. Because I don't know what she's doing. It's nice to watch. No, Tui, no! Okay, bye, Tui. No dragging the bed, please. Tui, no! Don't put it on your piss bed! Oh my god. Do not put the bed on your piss bed! Oh, she's putting it back. She's putting the bed back. She put it back. Tui, no! Tui! No! No! Tui! Tui, no! Don't do it! Do not put it on your piss bed. What are you doing? That's not a toy! Oh my god, she's going crazy! Because I'm streaming for too long. She's like, Mom, I hate it here. I'm so bored. I have all these toys, but I'm going to rip on my bed. I'm so bored. I hate you, Mom. It's fine. Just don't put it in your pee pad, okay? Just leave it right there. Good girl. You're putting it back. That's very nice of you. You're doing a good job. Okay. Okay, good job. You're doing great. Anyway, as I was saying. What does that mean? Interesting.
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility. The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens.
Mm-hmm.
What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself.
Yeah.
Did he have the strength to find out?
Yeah.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building. Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing.
Mm-hmm.
This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly?
Okay.
No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world?
Okay, hang on one second. Doggy's finally going potty. Oh, what the fuck? She lifted her leg while she was peeing! Are you a boy? Tui? She lifted her leg. Interesting. Okay. I didn't know that.
But here was the proof. The heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions. Happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working. All of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in, Stanley decided that this machinery would never... Blackness, and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over?
What's with the voice? What voice? What are you talking about? This one?
Yes. He had won.
I don't hear a voice.
He had defeated the machine, unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved. Where had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp? What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him, for it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all he needed to know. It was, perhaps, the only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door. Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin. The feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Hey, but what happened to my coworkers? Oh, we're here again.
Psst! Stanley!
Yeah?
Come over here! In the vent!
Okay.
I want to show you something!
Okay. Coffee nut. Gross.
Okay, you remember how cheap and unsatisfying the new Ultra Deluxe content turned out to be? Well,
yes.
It got me thinking about the past, and how much better the Stanley Parable used to be.
Okay.
So I made something special, and tucked it away here where the game's developers won't find it.
Oh my god.
Just our little secret. Take a look. I call it the Memory Zone. It's where I've been storing all my favorite memories so I can relive the peak experiences of my life whenever I want.
Ooh.
Experiences like the launch of the Stanley Parable on PC. You see, Stanley, doesn't the Memory Zone remind you of how wonderful Stanley Parable was before it was sullied with a cheap re-release? Remember back in October of 2013, when the game originally launched? Back then, video games had integrity. Back then, it all meant something. Oh, the waste.
Hi, Helvetica Standard Bold. I like your name. I wonder why the game asked me what my time was. I've never played the previous game, so I don't feel nostalgic. Don't play for 5 years?
And over here is where I keep reviews of the Stanley Parable. Like this stunning triumph of games journalism. 10 out of 10 from Destructoid.com. James Stephanie Sterling writes, and I quote, "Where so many games that aspire to be more than games end up less than any form of art, Stanley Parable strives and then succeeds to be every game ever created." Did you hear that, Stanley? Every game ever created. That's how grand and all-encompassing the original Stanley Parable was. It was literally every game ever created. It was Skyrim, it was Persona 3, it was all of them, and now it's nothing. It's no games at all. It isn't even the Stanley Parable anymore. It's just a husk now. A lifeless husk.
Oh, Demon, are you talking about the pins?
An hour of new elevator.
Yeah,
content.
Yeah. Was that you that sent the pins? If that is, then yeah. When I got it, I told you. Yeah. I keep it on my, I don't wear purses. I wear a little like fanny pack because they're cool. And I have the pin on my fanny pack and I wear it every day. Thank you. I loved it. It's such a freaking cool design. Thank you so much for that. Yeah. I love it.
Here's another moving passage, this time from
GameSpot.com.
The Stanley Parable is both a richly stimulating commentary on the nature of choice in games and one that offers some of the most enjoyable, surprising, and rewarding choices I've ever been confronted with in a game. 9 out of 10. Don't you get it, Stanley? The game was perfect. It didn't need anything else. It didn't need new content. It just needed to be left alone.
Schneedy,
to
yeah,
spend
it
the
is.
Rest of time collecting dust.
She's
in the
sleeping.
Hallowed hall of beloved video game memories.
I should probably play over there soon.
These were simpler times, Stanley. But I wouldn't give to go back to have it all over again. Wait, hang on. I don't recall this part of the Memory Zone before. What's this? What's down here? Oh, no. Oh, God, no. Stanley, it's a collection of reviews from Steam, the online video game distributor. I haven't looked at these in years.
Uh-oh.
I can't even imagine what's been collecting down here. Surely these reviews were glowing as well, weren't they? Honestly, I could not be bothered to play this game to full completion. The narrator is obnoxious and unfunny.
Can you imagine if this was yours and it got in the game?
To be more irritating than entertaining. Unfunny! I'm not trying to be funny. I'm trying to make a serious work of art.
I suppose I could write up a handful of gags to insert into the Stanley Parable, but the game is already such a densely layered web of profound philosophical insights that I can't even imagine where I'd have the room to stick them.
Oh, there's a lot of them.
Let's see what this one says. While the idea for the game is good, for someone who prefers non-linear games, his preachiness gets annoying fast. Preachy? Stanley? I'm not preachy, am I? You can tell me if I'm preachy. Honestly, you can. Oh, goodness. This is actually quite shocking for me. I had always thought of the game's dialogue as being rather terse to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
You can't know how much fluff I cut from the game to get it to feel as light and airy as it... Well, I always thought it did. What an awful memory to have to hold on to. These black marks are my otherwise unimpeachable track record.
Life is black.
I feel like a failure. Like I let these people down.
It's okay,
narrator.
Perhaps
the Stanley Parable isn't quite as sterling as I always... What's this one got to say? You constantly have to stop doing anything so the narrator can catch up with his long-winded explanations of what's happening. I wish there was a skip button. A skip button? Well, yes.
Okay.
Yes, I think we can do that. If I'm truly too preachy, then maybe letting you skip ahead for just a moment, surely it couldn't hurt.
Okay.
Not if it means we can strike these negative reviews from the record. Only positive reviews of the Stanley Parable. That's my motto today, and it's always been my motto. I'd do anything for the Captain Stanley. Yes, a skip button we shall have.
Okay. Skip.
And here it is. Oh, you're back, you see? You were only frozen in time for a few minutes, but it was plenty of time for me to deliver a long, rambling monologue full of Well, there, sport. You really did catch me rambling on a bit, didn't you? But that's the power of the button. The minute I start to go off on a thoughtless display of self-absorption, Okay, welcome back, Stanley. Now, I should say that the amount of time the button has been skipping through is becoming longer and longer. That last one was, well, I want to say maybe 30, 45 minutes? It's not unendurable by any means, but it's, well, there's really only so much I can ramble on to myself about. I know, it's shocking, isn't it? But at any rate, I do suggest that we not press the button again. I think the skip button has been aptly demonstrated, and we can say goodbye to it and just... Wait, how do we get out of here? Stanley, please don't push the button again. It's been 12 hours. You've just been frozen there. I don't know why the skips are getting longer, but they're really... Oh, Stanley, you're back. You're back. Oh, my goodness. I have someone to talk to again.
Hi, narrator.
Stanley, I think it's been a week. Or 2 weeks. I've been sitting here all that time.
Mm-hmm.
Just sitting here. Not a single person to speak with.
Yeah.
And you'd think that that's just how it's always been, right?
Yeah.
Me talking and you saying nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Would you think that it's exactly the same as always? Doesn't that feel like what we've already been doing? Me just talking? But it isn't, Stanley. It isn't the same at all.
Okay.
It isn't even close. Because I know you can't hear me once you push that button. That's what I'm realizing now, Stanley. I'm realizing that I needed to know that someone... Oh, hello. It's you. You're here again. Welcome. I have had time to think about you and about us and about everything we've been through.
Mister? Narrator? Okay. Oh, the clock. What's the beeping? May the beeping stop! I don't like the beeping! Make it stop! I don't like the beeping!
But they didn't understand the game was never meant to be funny. It was meant to have a point. It was meant to speak to the human condition. But where are the jokes? Where are the jokes? They bemoaned, they screamed, they gnashed their teeth and said, entertain us. It wasn't enough. They had to leave a pathetic little thumbs down review.
Narrator?
The end is never the end, 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 is never the end.
No, I'm not tickling, that was an accident.
End is never the end, 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 end is never the end, 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 is never the end. All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. Oh, good. You noticed my sign. Yes, I have something very exciting to show you.
Okay. New nail contact. Okay. New. Okay. It's the narrator.
You see, Stanley, I've been reflecting on the Stanley Parable. Okay. And about how roundly disappointing this ultra-deluxe version has turned out to be. The original Stanley Parable was a landmark.
And
any
thank
new
you.
Content for it should live up to that legacy. So forget this ultra-deluxe nonsense. I say we take it one step even further. Which is why I'm very proud to announce for the first time ever, the Stanley Parable 2.
Never the end again.
Yes, you see, isn't this far superior to a measly re-release with a few minor additions? Think of all the new territory we'll cover with a fully fledged sequel. An entirely new experience built from the ground up. Why, there are so many possibilities. It could go in so many different directions. This is what fans have truly been asking for.
Okay.
Calling it the Stanley Parable 2 is just so much catchier than Ultra Deluxe, don't you think? Ultra Deluxe? What does it even mean? But the Stanley Parable 2. Now that's an artistic statement right there. It's future-oriented. It screams progress and innovation and long-term franchising potential.
Thanks for attending my meeting. I like that one. Yeah, that's good.
Now, to be clear, I haven't quite nailed down what exactly the Stanley Parable 2 is going to be, but let's take a look at some of the features I've been developing for it. I figure that if I can loosely organize a handful of interesting concepts, that surely the game will sort of naturally spring up around them.
Okay.
It'll all work itself out. Game development is much more of a fuzzy magic than anything scientific or logical, really.
Okay. Looks nice. This is nice. Nice presentation.
Go on. Try out some of the new features.
Okay. The button that says the name of the player that is playing the game. Hear your name in the game? That's crazy talk.
For the Stanley Parable 2, I asked myself, what do players really want?
Read?
And of course,
Road to the
first and most
button.
Obvious answer is that they want to be individually recognized and validated as people. So with that in mind, my first addition to the game is this button, which speaks the name of the person. Sorry, I should have clarified. Right now, the button only says the name Jim. But of course, in the final game, this button will say your name, whatever name is. Here, let's have you roleplay as Jim to really simulate the full experience of this feature. Just play along. I promise you'll love it. Okay, here we go. Let's take a deep breath, clear your mind, forget whoever you are, and simply become a person named Jim. I want you to imagine yourself living as Jim. Sleeping and waking as Jim. Falling in love and being heartbroken as Jim. Seizing all of the world's possibilities as Jim. And as Jim, watching your dreams crumble into dust. Do you feel it deeply? Are you with
Jim?
Whoa, hold on. I wasn't finished setting up the backstory. If you don't properly roleplay as Jim, then you'll never understand the impact of this button. Otherwise, it's just a stupid button that says somebody else's name. Okay, we're doing it again, and this time let me finish first. Now, allow yourself to become Jim. Imagine you're... All right, fine, whatever. It's just a meaningless button that says Jim. Are you happy now? Get out of here. I'm done with this button. Why don't you go humiliate me in front of a different feature that I worked very hard on?
Okay. Hello? The grocery stores? Yeah, 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 okay. The grocery stores right here. Okay, here we go. We're going in this minute. Jim 3798. Good timing. Hi, Jim. Nice to meet you.
Maybe I'll only let people named Jim play the Stanley Parable too. Would appreciate what I've created here.
New office. What's that sound? That was weird. Why does it sound like that? That was a weird sound. I don't like that sound. There's something about a bucket. Everyone keeps talking about a bucket. I'll go for the bucket. I don't know what the bucket is.
A common complaint of the Stanley Parable was that it was confusing and paradoxical. That it engendered a chaotic sense of reckless despair in those who played it. Well, I'm happy to say that after much consideration, I've engineered a clever solution to this fundamental problem with the game. It's the Stanley Parable Reassurance Bucket. You see, Stanley, anytime you're holding the bucket, a sense of calm and ease will fill your mind and your heart. It's true. As long as you hold onto the bucket, the many disorienting contradictions of the Stanley Parable will feel perfectly normal and perhaps even comforting. You may even come to long for the gentle embrace of jarring cognitive dissonance while the bucket is in your arms.
The bucket?
And to be honest, it's a much more convenient solution for me than actually redesigning the game to be less uncomfortable.
Mm.
Can you imagine what a pain in the ass that would be?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, the bucket is the perfect solution.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, give it a try. Can you feel it?
Mm-mm.
The glow of comfort, even in the face of crushing despair, must already be sweeping through your body. And in fact, can I say that I do believe the bucket lends you an air of charisma as well? I think that just holding it has made you the slightest bit more attractive as a person. The benefits of the bucket seem to go on, don't they? All this and more await you in the Stanley Parable 2.
Okay. Oh, I have a bucket now.
Does anyone give out awards for most enjoyable bucket in a video game? Okay, I'll be honest, I haven't yet decided on this one.
I think that in the new version,
the office could use a bit of decoration, like balloons. But I'm undecided on Get Well Someday and Happy 12th Birthday. Which would you go
with? This one!
You know, sometimes when you solicit another person's opinion, it makes you realize that you knew which one you actually really wanted all along. Happy 12th birthday,
asshole.
Niece, it is.
You're a fucking douchebag. Now they're everywhere. Wow, way to rub it in my fucking face.
Oh, actually, maybe I should have gone with... No. Nope, I've made my decision. We're moving on.
Pretty new easy achievement. Yeah, I love Cheevos. Pull the lever, receive your new achievement. No more steps. Okay.
Now, here's something special. You remember that broken test achievement that got left in the game on accident?
Yeah.
Well, I'm developing a technology to simply give you the achievement.
Okay.
Yes. You see, you'll come to this lever, and when you pull it, the achievement will be given. Okay, perhaps I should have clarified. This is technology that will exist. Right now, the achievement is still fully broken. I'm not a wizard, Stanley, but I guarantee it will be fixed.
I'm gonna leave a bad review.
To at last satisfy the hordes of ravenous fans all over the world who have been uproariously demanding this feature. Gamers, we hear you, and I promise it will happen.
Give it to me. Bucket! Oh my god, I'm gonna get the fuck out of here. I lied about the achievements. I'm carrying around a fucking bucket that I can't fucking drop. Doesn't even say my fucking name. My name's not even Jim. Oh my god, I'm gonna leave a bad review.
What else? What other exhibits haven't we seen yet?
Oh, the jump circle. I've already done that one.
You know what? Let's bring the jump circle back for Stanley Parable 2 as well. It's a
idea.
You already spent all your jumps the first time we saw the jump circle.
Yeah.
Oh well. I suppose it can just be a nice decorative piece.
Fuck
then.
Off. All collectibles. I like that. Okay. Can you find them? Okay.
Ah. Collectibles. Now it's a real video game.
Yeah.
In Stanley Parable 2, you'll run around gathering up these miniature Stanley figurines.
Yeah.
And what's truly innovative is that there will be no reward for collecting all of them.
Oh, cool.
I don't want to stifle the intrinsic joy of watching a number go up.
Shit,
you simply collect all of them, and then you move the hell on with your unremarkable life.
Yeah! I got one. Okay. Collect them all. Yeah, fuck it. I like that one. That was a good one. Good job.
God, it really is the worst when you collect everything in a video game and then they give you a big fancy reward for it.
Yeah, like a Chivo.
Tragic.
You're this fucking loser. Jump circle. This map is number 5. Free achievement. That's a lie. The button that says the name of the button is also a lie. Merch. Okay, we should check out the merch one. Okay, settings world champion. I don't even know what that fucking means. I'm fine. Map. Stanley Parable Reassured. Okay, yeah, I picked that one up. Office decorations. Yeah, you check that one. Epilogue. Collectibles. Yeah, that's just. That's collectibles, right? Yeah, okay. Infinite Hall. Where's Infinite Hall? Okay. Yeah! Oh, this looks. Fun! Is it here? No. Okay. Down here. opening rooms. Depth infinite. Okay. Infinity hole entrance. Okay. Just, you know, you start at the top and you just keep going. Yeah. That sounds pretty right. That sounds right. Okay, let's
Stanley,
go.
Here's an idea that I'm truly fond of.
Okay.
It's never been done before in a video game.
Mm-hmm.
This is, in fact, a hole that you can fall down forever.
Okay.
Woo! Falling. You can fall until the end of time, if you like. A stunning leap forward. You see? Isn't it wonderful?
Yeah.
One of my most ingenious concoctions, if I do say so. Now then, since you've gotten to see the infinite hole, you can press the teleport button to pop back up to the top, and we can continue onward. Now, I don't mean to be a bummer, but I do recommend you use the teleport button to go back to the top. Maybe do it on the sooner rather than later spectrum of things. Okay, Stanley, I don't know quite how to say this tactfully, but it's possible that I slightly exaggerated the infinite nature of the hole. Is it a very, very deep hole? To be certain it is. It's an extremely deep hole. I don't want anyone to say that it isn't an astonishingly deep hole. It is. Is it infinite? Well, that sort of depends on your definition of infinity. From one perspective, the infinite is merely philosophical in nature. It's more of a... Okay, well, good for you. You found the bottom of the hole. You found me out, Stanley.
You
lied. I'm a liar and a cheat, and you're so clever. Look, I think the issue here
you ruined
is
my
just
bit
that you're
on my stream.
Fascinated by falling. What normal person actually
me.
Wants to fall?
Me! That was the fucking bit!
I figured the hole was as deep as anyone would actually need. Don't
I
you
wrote
put
the
this
credits.
On me?
I did, wait,
Maybe
I...
you're the problem.
And everything, and you... Oh, my God, I hate this fucking
Look,
guy.
Things got a little heated there. I think we both said some things we didn't mean.
Why here.
Don't we just
Get me
put
out of here.
All this behind us and agree to just call the hole mostly infinite?
No, it's not even close.
You... Then go ahead and press the teleport button to warp up to the top of the hole and we can move on. I'll just be up here when you're ready. Great. Now, I'm very excited to show you even more. Oh, for heaven. You see? I was right. The problem is you.
No.
The problem is that you like holes too much.
You like holes too much.
Don't need to see it all, but not you. Oh, no. You have a weird sort of... Oh. Did the hole seem even shorter to you this time? I couldn't help but feel like you spent a little less time in there than you did before. I mean, admittedly, I didn't make an infinite hole, but I didn't think it was that infinite. Well, I suppose once again there's nothing to do here. If you decide you've had enough of the hole, you can hit the teleport button and come join me up above. Had enough? I'm positively thrilled. Gosh, how could I have guessed? You're back in the hole. If this starts to become a thing where... Wow. Okay. Yes. I'm starting to become extremely certain that the hole is not only not infinite, but that it's growing steadily less and less infinite. I suspect that I'm starting to hit the point where it's no longer feasible to call the hole infinitely deep, even by the lax overall standards for accountability and marketing. What's going on here? Stanley, I have no explanation for the uncertain nature of the hole's length. Here, let's try something. Let's pop back up to the top, and we'll see if it gets any shorter. Well, there it is. The shame of my lie has come to haunt me.
Fucking...
Is this still appealing to you?
You suck!
I know you're obsessed with holes, but at this depth, I just can't see this scratching the itch. Oh, who am I to judge? You just do whatever it is you're here to do.
Bucket.
Hit the teleport button when you're ready to move on. Is the teleport button not working? You sure? Well, I mean, I really don't have an explanation. Still nothing. Well, I suppose there is one thing I can do to fix this. I'm out. Goodbye, Stanley. You couldn't bear to be away from the hole, and now you'll get more time with it than you could ever have asked for. It's a win for everyone. You get to be with the hole, I get to do literally anything else.
Okay, bye-bye.
Take care, Stanley.
Bye.
I hope you and the hole have a wonderful rest of eternity together.
Okay. Whew. Damn, finally the loser is gone. Jesus Christ. That guy took fucking forever to leave. Every pause button... Hello? Is that music? Is that music playing? Hello? Wait. What the fuck? Hole? Where are we going, Hole? Meeting at 2 p.m. Fuck, I think I missed that management. Bye.
Oh, good, you're awake. It seems you had sort of dozed off there, drifting away into dreamland. But we can't have that, Stanley, because this hole is just so darn fascinating that I want you to be wide awake for every second of it. You don't want to miss a single moment. So how about if I just pop in from time to time and wake you up to keep you really, truly focused on the hole? From the looks of things, you and I will have many, many years here in this hole, and I'm looking forward to all of them. Stay alert, Stanley. I'll be back.
Thank you so much. Can I get up? Hello? Wait. We're going down again? That was fun.
Here we are. Go on, try out some of the new features.
Merch was fun. Okay, obsequations, collectibles. We did the collectibles. We did new content. This is broken. Those are chairs. Those screenshots. And we had some beautiful too. We went there. I want to leave now. I don't know how much more there is. There's not a lot more to this game. Exit. I want to exit now. I'm bored. Thank you! Pon. Can you please tell me how to pronounce it properly? I'm reading pocket. Pocket-e-agent. You guys are saying pon. Punk Leo. Pocket! Is it Pocket? Pocket! Pocket? Hello, Pocket! Thank you so much for the raid. I really appreciate it. Hi, everyone. Welcome.
Excuse me. That was my co-host. Hello. Welcome. I do have a dog. Yes, thank you for asking. I am Lena Lazar. I have a dog. Welcome. Hi, Tui. Good morning. Hi. And also my co-host.
Me! I'm the one that hosts the show. Yeah, don't listen to that nerd up there. She's weird. Anyway, we're playing Stanley Parable.
Stanley, yes. Excuse me. We're playing Stanley Parable. Thank you so much, Sarade, and bringing your community over here. I appreciate it. I think most people take more than one session to finish the game. How much more? 10 hours? Are you kidding me?
10 hours? Oh, Jesus. I'm kind of done with it now. I haven't even seen half of it. I'm done now. Like, I'm done. I'm good. Like, I seize what I need to seize. I seize it. I seize all the thing. Game big. Well, I mean, it seems like the point is the narrator just sends you to do things you don't expect. And you go, ooh, wow. And then that's it.
All right. Have you seen everything you wanted to? Ready to move on now?
Yeah. I'm done. I'm bored. Have a good sleep. Or both.
So, Stanley, what do you think? Do you like all of the new features?
Sure.
Yes, I know it's not exactly clear yet how exactly these features will come together as one single coherent video game, but I can feel it in my soul. It's going to work. There's definitely a good game in there somewhere. Say, let's do an experiment. I'll arrange these new features together, and we'll see whether or not it coheres into a meaningful gameplay experience.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Are you ready? Here it is. I give you the Stanley Parable 2.
Woohoo! I love this. This looks really good, narrator.
Well, I mean, there's potential here, right?
It's yeah.
Sort of.
Got okay, the hole. Got the
hold
achievement.
On. Let
the
me
balloons.
Do a different arrangement.
Okay.
Okay. Yes. Yes. This is much better. I feel good about this. Here we go. Version 2.
I like the carpets.
Who am I kidding, Stanley?
King
this
Arthur
isn't
Bye.
A coherent video
Thank
game
you.
At all. It's a lot of gags.
And I do very much enjoy creating gags, but they don't add up to anything.
Meow.
I wanted more than anything to create a sequel that would capture all the magic of the first game. I wanted fans to love it. No matter how good these gags are, they won't stand on their own. They would need the structure and the gameplay of the original. Wait. Maybe that's it. I can take the original Stanley Parable and simply, well, insert a few of my new features into it. Tastefully, of course.
Okay.
With respect.
Yeah.
With care for the vision and integrity of the original game.
Okay.
Would it possibly work?
Yeah.
I suppose it could. But it would need a really, really tremendous title screen.
Okay.
A title screen that says with bold and uncompromising conviction, this is the Stanley Parable 2.
Okay.
Let me see if I can whip something up.
Okay.
All right, perfect.
What's that, Detective?
Go ahead. Take a look.
I'm ready. Oh. Okay.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day.
I will wait. The sequel is now paused. I like these little changes throughout the game. I think that's pretty cool. I think it's clever. Boop, 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 boop. Oh, dog is about to go to the bathroom here. I'm gonna hit up Akiwa. I don't want her to get in trouble. She okay? No, she only peed. Dang it. Good girl. You did so good. I'm so proud of you. Good girl. She peed. She peed. She peed. She just did a little wee-wee. Just a little wee-wee. I missed the barcode. Oh, well, okay. Are we done with ads? The non-ads flew by. Okay. Oh, I love the balloon.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office.
Hi, Felix. Welcome back for a whole year. A tier 3.
Did it advance the story in any way?
She stepped in it! That's a really long time. Hi! Dion, thank you so much for being around for 29 months on the channel. I really appreciate that. Thank you. That was very nice. Okay, I gotta wrap up a little soon. This is Spy. Thank you so much. Almost a year. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that. Thank you. Welcome back.
Stanley felt the bucket calling to him, oh, begging him to pick it up.
Where's the bucket?
Why was he not doing it?
Where's the bucket? Where's the bucket? Where's the bucket? Bucket! No, I don't need the bucket.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Standing now in this incredible room, Stanley for the first, but eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left. And so he detoured through the maintenance section, walked straight ahead to the opposite door, and got back on track.
Bean, hi! Welcome back for 3 months! Oh shit, Lena, you stream, let's go! Yeah,
Yet there was not a single person here either.
I was very late
feeling
to the
wave
stream.
Of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Hoping he might come into a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Baby. Okay, what if we play with Doggy and wrap up the stream because I haven't played with her and she was sick and I feel really bad and I want to play with her. Yeah, I want to play with her. But what do I do about the game? The sequel's now paused. Wait, let's just see. Wait, what happens if we go in? Is it going to be different? I want to keep going.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Mm. What could it mean, he wondered. Desperate for answers, he began turning the room over, looking for clues that might unravel the situation. Okay. Until at last, he discovered a keypad behind the boss's desk. Mm. But alas, no code. For this keypad guarded the terrible secret that...
Okay, what kind of music? Let's see. Non-copyright anime lo-fi. Bucket is DLC content. Oh, okay. I gotta change your keypad. Oh, Zalix! Oh my god, thank you so much. I really appreciate that. Thank you so much. That was very nice of you. Okay. Puppy break. Okay. Hey, can you change it to just chatting? Happy break. Oh, wait, I can do it. Okay, I won't be able to hear you. I put on sucky.
Thank you.
Hi. That was that. What did I miss? Did you have a good stream today? Oh, me. Mr. Ghost played with a VTuber. Yeah, I saw that. The model was being a little weird. Where's my mouth? Yeah, that was good. So tell me more. Also, Fair Harris, welcome back. Almost an entire year. Thank you so much. Hi. Tell me more about Stanley Parable. Like a 10-hour game? I don't know. Everyone says that they really, really like it, but I'm not sure how I feel. Like, I think it was interesting and clever and fun. So I don't know. I'm not sure how I feel. I think it was fun for what it was. It's not a 10-hour game. It's not for everyone. It's unique. I got the gist of the idea an hour in, but I cannot imagine playing that game for 5 hours. I just cannot. Also, oh my God, look at her. Thoughts on Pikachu? Oh, he's alright. My dog and I were watching on the TV from the couch and I fell asleep. Dude, that's always the best time. It's a game you come next day to play again. Okay. Yeah, that's actually a cat toy. I think that's why Shoyu came around. She loves that toy. Look at her. God, she's amazing.
Good night, Star Lancer. You feel better soon, okay? I love her, dude. On the recommended channel, and we'll see how we feel. Feeling a bit ill? Oh no, feel better. I was watching this stream while in bed dying from a cold. Oh, I'm really glad. All I could ever hope for is for people to feel good, feel happy, feel cozy. Oh my god, no way, I think I've stumbled upon the best stream.
You got that right. Wait, why do I sound normal now? What the fuck? Where's my gremlin? Gremlin! Why is it back on hard tune?
What the fuck? Anyway. Yeah, we got a puppy cam up in here. A little bit of this. And a little bit of that. A little bit of this. And a little bit of that. Yeah, let's get a raid going here. While we watch her, shall we? Look at her get her food out. She doesn't want to pick it up with her mouth, so she takes it out. Alright guys, I'll see you tomorrow morning early for a Veil collab with Silver Veil and Mama Veil and Kunsetsu and Pix. Just look at her eat her food like that. Just a little princess, little piss baby princess. Look at that. She's like, get it out, man. I don't want to get it with my face. Ugh, get it out. Yeah, I got a cookie. All right, I'll miss you guys. Really improved the time in the office? Good. Get it out. God damn it. All right. I will see you guys early tomorrow. Mwah! Thank you for the fun time today, and I will see you soon in a few hours, probably, because it's in the morning. Piss Puppy Raid! Then I hope you have a good sleep. Yeah. Piss Puppy! Piss Puppy Raid! Goodbye! Goodbye! Goodbye!